Today we're going to be talking about the top things that you must know about Stranger Things Season 4. No doubt that Stranger Things is one of the most loved and popular series running among all networks around the world. It first premiered on Netflix in 2016, and three seasons have already aired, and now fans of the show are waiting for Stranger Things Season 4. The new season, which was supposed to release in early 2021, has now seen a delay of up to 1 year due to the pandemic-induced restrictions on shooting and post-production. Stick around until number one, as this coverage of the most awaited show on Netflix is something that you don't want to miss out on. We don't want to spoil the fun, so grab a seat and let's begin. Before we go any further, remember to smash that like button, subscribe to our channel for more content, and watch until the end of the video. Let's go! Number 8. A 2022 release for Season 4. While Netflix never revealed an official Stranger Things Season 4 release date, it has been confirmed that the series will be landing in 2022. This is the first season of Stranger Things to feature so many teasers, which we're going to discuss in detail next. Typical of Netflix to keep the release dates, trailers, and even teasers of their shows under tight wraps. But they have kept the hype going by releasing minute and relevant information throughout this period, through the cast of the show. There's still no specific date beyond that though, but for now fans can rest easy knowing that the new season is just around the corner and can release on a short notice. Number 7. A case of teasers and trailers. Following some Twitter teasers, the first teaser released, which officially confirmed Stranger Things Season 4, featured the Season 4 logo. This is strangled by the living vines of the Upside Down. It also has a clock chiming. The video concludes with the message, "We're not in Hawkins anymore." Can we expect the curtain to be drawn back on the Upside Down secrets? Then, May 2021 brought with us a new teaser trailer for a minute-long clip that shows us the test subjects at Hawkins National Laboratory gently going about their daily lives in the ominously titled Rainbow Room. It's a flashback scene and we can hear Eleven's labored breathing emanating from her room. Eleven, are you listening? Matthew Modine's Dr. Brenner, the one-time director of the lab, asks cryptic. Then in August 2021, a third and yet another teaser trailer was released. In this, Eleven is seen with a new look and held back by a shadowy government agent in one moment. In another teaser, Hopper looks to have broken out of Russian captivity in some way or another, and is bringing the heat with a flamethrower. And the last teaser revealed by Netflix at their Tudum event reveals a new mysterious location, Creel House, described by the Duffer Brothers as a super important location. Number 6. Returning cast. So far, it's confirmed that the lead ensemble of the show will be returning to the ever-successful show, along with the more popular Millie Bobby Brown as Eleven, who is still interested in the future of the show, Noah Schnapp as Will, Finn Wolfhard as Mike, Gato Matarazzo as Dustin, and Kayla McCollin as Lucas. Sadie Sink as Max, Charlie Heaton as Jonathan, Natalie Dyer as Nancy are all going to be present among the teenage cast, as expected. Among the seasoned, Winona Ryder as Joyce, Cara Buono as Karen, and the season-stealing Maya Hawke as Robin will return. And finally, there's a bald-headed David Harbour as Hopper, whose return was the most suspenseful among the cast in the major storyline. Number 5. The Freshers. Onto the newcomers, Stranger Things Season 4 has added three regulars to proceedings. Jamie Campbell Bauer will play Peter Bollard, who is described as being an elderly at a psychiatric hospital, and is tired of the brutality he's witnessed day after day. That sure sounds like a character with links to Eleven's origins. Eduardo Franco joins the cast as Argyle, Jonathan's new best friend and a fun-loving stoner who proudly delivers delicious pies for Surfer Boy Pizza. Rounding out the new regulars is Joseph Quinn as Eddie Munson, who runs the Hellfire Club. Joining those three regulars are eight recurring characters. Sherman Augustus will portray Lieutenant Colonel Sullivan, who believes he can stop the evil at Hawkins. Mason Dye will play Jason Carver, a rich, handsome teenager who's dating the most popular girl in school. Nikola Jericho will play Yuri, a seedy and unpredictable Russian smuggler who loves bad jokes, cold hard cash, and crunchy style peanut butter. Russian? Potentially working with Hopper in Russia then? Robert Englund is set to appear as Victor Creel, a disturbed and intimidating man who is imprisoned in a psychiatric hospital for a gruesome murder in the 50s. Plus, there's Tom Washia, who will play Dmitri, a Russian prison guard who befriends Hopper. That's not all the new additions, though. Amy Beth McNulty joins the cast as Vicky, described as a cool, fast-talking band nerd who catches the eye of one of our beloved heroes. Miles Truitt is set to play basketball star Patrick, while Regina Ting Chen will play guidance counselor Miss Kelly, and Grace Van Deen is lead cheerleader Chrissy, who's concealing a dark secret. Tell us what you think about Season 4 of Stranger Things after the end of this video in the comment section down below. Number 4, episodes and titles. Stranger Things Season 4 will be 8 episodes long, which will be consistent with Seasons 1 and 3, though one episode behind Season 2. However, the Stranger Things scriptwriters have since revealed that they've written 9 episodes worth of scripts. In a tweet, the 9 scripts were shown all piled up on top of each other. Natalie Dyer, who plays Nancy, has since confirmed this, saying that the delay to filming has allowed the two screenwriters to finish everything before filming, something that didn't happen with the previous seasons. More interesting is the title of episode 1. Yes, we've had confirmation of the name at the Stranger Things Season 4 premiere, all thanks to the show's official writers' Twitter accounts. The episode is titled The Hellfire Club, and along with the image, a message reads, "Looking for new members. Are you in?" The Hellfire Club is a group of villains who have faced off against the X-Men numerous times. Numerous commentators have drawn comparisons between Eleven and Jean Grey. Will the telepathic teenager be about to break bad? Well, perhaps not. Number 3, Stranger Things Season 5 and Future. Fear not, Stranger Things fans, Season 4 will not be the last. Sure, Millie Bobby Brown may be leading new Netflix movies like Enola Holmes, but the actor hasn't left the series that made her a household name behind just yet. Talking to The Hollywood Reporter, showrunner Ross Duffer said that Season 4 won't be the end. They already have an end and also know when it is. He added that the coronavirus pandemic has given them time to look ahead, figure out what's best for the show. How many more seasons will there be? That remains to be seen. The Duffer brothers did not confirm. Whatever the case is, though, there will be more Stranger Things after Season 4, and we are very thankful for that. Number 2, biggest and scariest yet. Gene Keery, who plays Steve Harrington, told us that he's very excited about Stranger Things Season 4, even if that instantly iconic Scoops Ahoy outfit has been retired. He said that this is definitely going to be a lot scarier than prior years, because last year was pretty dark. Along the same line, the Duffer brothers have teased a different tone this time around. Every time we go to a new season, we want it to have a different feel and a different tone, they recently said. While they went no further, it wouldn't be a leap to see Stranger Things getting scarier in the coming seasons. Finn Wolfhard also told CBC's Radio Q this season will be a lot darker. Similarly, Gaten Matarazzo has spoken about Season 4's tone to ET Online. He said, "When it comes to the tone of the season, I think the tone is definitely matured for sure. And I think Matt and Ross Duffer do that on purpose because I think they want their show to mature with their kids. As we are growing older as people, we have to grow older as characters. They're confronted by this issue, but they embrace it and they use it to their advantage. And they don't freak out when we get taller or when our voices drop or anything like that. They use it as they want it as ammunition for their writing. It's incredible what they can do. Working with them, it's just exceptional. It always has been." Natalia Dyer also teased about how the new series will be really big. Sean Levy, who acts as an executive producer, went one step further and said Stranger Things will be better than ever with Season 4. So, in the many, many months where the Stranger Things cast and crew were twiddling their thumbs, the creators were able to endlessly tweak and tinker with the scripts, instead of literally writing things during the filming. That can only be a good thing. Number 1, major plot. Murray Bauman, the Russian-speaking conspiracy theory, who played a key role in Season 3, has hinted that he knows something about Hopper's whereabouts and could play a key part in bringing him back to Hawkins. As CNET revealed, if you call Murray's home phone number, 618-625-8313, according to the show, you receive the following answerphone message. "Hi, you have reached the residence of Murray Bauman. Mom, if this is you, please hang up and call me between the hours of 5 and 6pm, as previously discussed. Okay? If this is Joyce, Joyce, thank you for calling. I have been trying to reach you. I have an update. It's about, well, it's probably best if we speak in person. It's not good or bad, but it's something. Reports have indicated that Season 4 will film in New Mexico, home to the likes of Breaking Bad, Better Call Saul, and a certain major conspiracy theory. Those of you who know about UFO history, though, can point to at least one major location of interest in New Mexico, Roswell. where evidence of aliens was reportedly spotted in 1947. The event grew in premise and prominence in the late 1970s to the early 1980s. Perhaps Borman is going to go exploring. Expect Stranger Things Season 4 to explore how Eleven is coping now that her telekinetic powers have deserted her, and how she's dealing with life after Hopper, living with the Byers in a new town. That's all for today, guys. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time.